Hi, Mum. Happy 80th birthday, which I have to say doesn't trip off the tongue very easily. You're looking very well and are more sprightly than your age would suggest. My message to you is a big thank you for being my mum. By having kids myself, I now recognise lots of memories of all the school grinds and the school lunches and the taxiing backwards and forwards to various different discos and parties, and indeed the parties in Fox Rock and all the holidays. So thank you. So happy birthday. Enjoy the day. Enjoy the year. And I'm looking forward to giving you a proper hug. What we now have is a fantastic collection of memories, photos, videos, and indeed many messages from your friends who obviously would love to have been able to be here to celebrate it physically, but have sent messages of kindness and their own memories directly to yourself. Okay, so looking forward to seeing you soon. Enjoy and happy birthday.
Sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning.
Hi, Hylary. Happy birthday to you. Can you believe it? We have known each other 66 years. And you know, all I remember about you is that you're always great fun. And I think that's a great thing to be able to say. When I met you first, I used to trail you and Jean places, and I wasn't always very popular, I know. But anyway, it was good. And excuse me, I hope that you have a great day. You know, I know we can't all celebrate with you, but we will be thinking of you, and I surely will raise a glass. And I wish you many, many more very happy birthdays. And by the way, I will now delete what you owe me from your introduction to Peter. I think it's lasted so long. It was great. Okay, love. All the very best. Bye.
And the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Hill, happy birthday to you. Hip hip hooray! I have to say something to you now, and I've written it down, but I tried to do it without reading it. It suddenly occurred to me that you are one of the only people in the world that I have known for 80 years. And I think that's really special. When my father died in 1946, I stayed at your house in Slemish Road for at least 1 or 2 weeks. And while I was there, your mother gave me a children's hymn book, a beautiful children's hymn book with full page pictures in it. And that has been for most of my life really a very treasured book for me, and I still have it. We often bring up our youth and all the things we did together, and Castle Knock and a and Dublin and the boys, and we often bring that up when we're talking to each other. And what I really appreciate is you always know all the names and you keep me up to date on all of them. And I really like that. Our lives took different paths when I moved to Holland, but we always kept in touch. And Kate and I always appreciated you coming to Holland to see us. Most of your visits were, of course, parties and all kinds of things like that. I remember one of the first times you came, we went to have dinner in Amsterdam. Big treat at that time. And we walked, as we walked through the Kalverstraat, you looked down at your feet in horror because you still had your slippers on. We were all dolled up to go out and you had your slippers on. Well, we had a good laugh at that. And in fact, in Amsterdam, it didn't make a bit of difference. Nobody noticed. Now, we've had so many parties with you and Peter, and you know most of our friends really well now. And by the way, they all send you their love and best wishes. You have been to the celebrations for, at the time, the Queen's Day, all dressed up in orange, and the first drink was at 11 in a pub in Amsterdam, and that's the way it went on all day. Great fun. You've been to rowing races, gone sailing and cycling, even through Amsterdam for one party. You've seen Sinterklaas and got presents from him. You've sang many, many songs and dressed up many, many times for different occasions, Halloween being a highlight. Hill, there are so many really wonderful memories we have together, but it's still hard to believe we are 80. 80. It sounds so old, but we're not old. And hopefully we will continue to make many, many more memories together in the future. I've picked out a few photos for you. There are so many, it's really hard to choose. But I really hope we see each other very soon again, and then we can laugh and remiss together. Thank you for not only being my cousin, but also a very dear friend over all the ups and downs of 80 years. I will raise a glass to you on your birthday and hopefully many, many more times together. Have a great day, despite all the restrictions. Lots and lots of love, Ev.
You're begging and raining over your head, begging to deep over things unsaid, begging to water, we're begging to water. I'm leaving a last call for your heart, begging for so long, won't you come? Begging to water, we're begging to water. The night fell slowly on our glory days. I lie awake to see you fade away. You're lost without a trace. And when you're hiding on the water, I'll be waiting till you're ready for my love. When you washed away your sorrow, I'll be right.
It is my very great pleasure to record a greeting and a wish that you have an absolutely wonderful 80th birthday. Just like Ev, it's such a shame there's no chance of a get-together, but you have a lovely daughter who is putting together a surprise for you, hopefully to lift your spirits. I can think back to Christchurch Rathgar, such a good while ago now, but I am particularly remembering things like your wonderful parties and especially your always gorgeous food in your dinner parties. And it's a shame that we can't get together at all at this time, but hopefully as the year goes on, I'll be able to make you an Irish coffee, you and Peter, as William always did, his specialty. I remember your haven in British Bay, where you were kind enough to have me and my grandchildren many times, and they always thought it was heaven.
You're ready for my love when you washed away the sorrow. I'll be ready. Back against the door. Your life is easy on the water, not anymore. I'm feeling the weight that's on the shore. I see your dark lights in the road. I'm fighting the stream that pulls you under, not anymore. 'Cause I will go with you. I will go with you. I will go with you. 'Cause I will go to win your heart and
to you. I hope to see you soon in British Bay. Okay.
Back in the water, back in the water. I'm waiting for so long, won't you hide? I'm trading your darkness for the light. Back in the water, back in the water. The night fell slowly on our glory days. And when your heart
going to toast you. I hope the wine has kept as well as you have.
Cheers.
Cheers.
As in all your fears, what took away your faith from here? Back in the water, back in the water. I'm waiting for so long, won't you hide? Trading your darkness for the light. Back in the water.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Hylary. Happy birthday to you. Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray. Congratulations on your 80th birthday. Have a wonderful day and enjoy every minute. Lots of love.
Cheers.
Hi Hylary, I can't believe that we're all going to be 80 this year. It really only seems like yesterday that we were all teenagers, going to the dances and only worrying about what we'd wear to the dances. And would it be Mayfield or Dunster Stratford, Rathfarnham, Andrews and the infamous KH? And we all had a great time and we really enjoyed it. Sure, we're all teenagers in our hearts. So have a lovely birthday and have a great day.
Hi Hylary, happy birthday, hope you enjoy the day. I can't believe that you're 80, you know, it's hard to take it. You look much younger and you're always in great form. We always have a bit of a laugh when we meet up and we've good memories. And I look forward to meeting you again in the not too distant future. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday Hylary.
Bye.
Bye. Hi Hylary. On behalf of Brian, Georgie and Molly, I'd like to wish you a very happy 80th birthday. It seems ridiculous wishing you an 80th because you look so good. So whatever pink tablets you're on, please will you keep me a few. The other thing I'd like to say on a slightly more serious note is thank you for being such terrific neighbours. Down in British, when Brian and I came back 10 years ago, you couldn't have been more welcoming. The pot of coffee was always on,
and also the glass of wine. So Hylary, I hope you have the best possible birthday on the 18th with loads of virtual hugs from your wonderful family, and we'll be thinking of you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Oma. 80, incredible achievement. I'm just so sorry that we're not there to celebrate it with you, but when all this is over, we look forward to celebrating with the two of you. So lots and lots of love and such a huge happy birthday. Mwah.
There's a place I go to when no one knows me. It's not lonely, it's a necessary thing. It's a place I made up, found out what I made. The nights I've stayed up, counting stars and fighting sleep. Let it wash over me, I'm ready to lose my feet. Take me off to the place where one reviews life's mystery. Steady on down the line, lose every sense of time.
Happy birthday, Emma. I hope you have an amazing day, and thank you so much for the amazing memories, and I hope you can make loads more moments like those in 2021.
Happy birthday, Oma. You look great for your age, and I hope you enjoy your day.
Happy birthday. I really hope you have a very good day, because you're the best grandmother ever.
Happy birthday, Hylary.
Happy birthday for Thursday. Congratulations on reaching a milestone, and well done, and have a wonderful day, and let's hope we all have a better year. Take care.
Take care.
Hi, Hylary. Happy birthday, and what a special birthday it is. And little did I realize that we actually know each other 21 years, believe it or not, all because of your beloved daughter. So, you know, yourself and Peter always made me very welcome when I joined the family, and I feel now I'm part of the Protestant community, and I brought value from my own roots into your community. And one of the things I've always really admired about yourself and Peter is the work you do in Tolo Church and the parish. But people might be forgiven for thinking that you're all goody two shoes, but I know the truth, and you know I do, that you actually have a bit of a dodgy mind, and I'm going to show you an example of that. So I've written you a limerick. Here we go. There was a young woman, Hylary, from Fox Rock, whose husband, Peter, had a big... Now, I'm going to stop it right there because I know you're probably laughing right now, and this to illustrate my point, that you just have a dirty mind. Let's just call it as it is, and that's okay. You're 80 now, you can kind of do whatever you like, but I'm just pointing out, don't be the goody two-shoes, let's talk real. So let me take it from the start, finish it, just to show you the rest of it. There was a young woman, Hylary, from Fox Rock, whose husband, Peter, had a big toolbox. One day, Peter took out his massive drill, Hylary let out a big shrill, only to be disappointed because Peter put up an old clock. Anyway, I know you're still laughing because of your dodgy mind. Regardless, I hope you have a great day, a great evening, and I'm really looking forward to celebrating your birthday and all the birthdays of the family when we get to the other side of this unusual time. Bye.
There's a place I go to when no one knows me. It's not lonely, it's a necessary thing. It's a place I made up, found out what I made up. The nights I've stayed up, counting stars and fighting sleep. Let it wash over me.
Happy birthday. Have an amazing day.
Happy birthday, and I hope you have an amazing day. So I think I should mention that you're actually one of the few people who can actually make me laugh when I'm in a grumpy mood. I think you know what I mean by that. And also that you're actually one of the best cooks. Like, Mum could literally make the exact same recipe, exact same ingredients and everything, except yours always managed to taste better. No offense, Mum. And I love our outings when we go out every so often in the year when it's just the two of us. It's always one of the best bits. And I think you'll always be remembered as the person who brings the best pajamas and the most comfortable and the cutest ones as well. Anyway, have an amazing day and love you loads.
Lose every sense of time, take it all in and wake up, that's my part.
Do you remember, Pete, when we first stepped out? You had the pinstripe suit. You wouldn't open your mouth. Still, you look lovely, except your shirt was sticking out. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
And the day we went to the Phoenix Park.
to look at the deer and sit in the grass. And you held my hand and asked for a kiss. For I wouldn't give in, because I knew it was a mortal sin. And then you said you loved me and promised a ring. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
I'm picking the winkles on British Bay Strand. And the tide came in nearly drowned our gran, with a pusher home in a three-wheeled pram. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
And do you remember the day you changed me name? You couldn't find the ring and Gran started praying. She looked through your waistcoat and she poked you round. And when she looked through your pockets, your trousers fell down. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
Oh, and the singing and dancing back at the house. Come to think of it, you were as quiet as a mouse. Ah, you shouldn't have put whiskey in Gran's bottle of stout. We thought she was dead and we found her lying on the wedding bed. But it was gas and it was grand. Except you to sleep with me brother Stan. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
Well, 'tis 60 long years we've been knocking about. You're much the same. I haven't changed, except me teeth are me own and you've got gout. But you still look lovely. Except your shirt's still sticking out. Do you remember, Pete?
Do I remember? Will I ever forget?
Hello, Hylary and Peter. Happy birthday, Hylary. This is your payback now for doing it for us, for our anniversary. So we hope you have a lovely day and that you have many, many more birthdays to come. And that goes for you too, Peter. So have a lovely day and a lovely birthday.
Happy birthday, Hylary. I presume it's your 50th birthday. But anyway, I hope you have a lovely day, and you and Peter have a lovely time. Bye.
Bye.
Hi Hylary, many happy returns today. I hope you have a lovely birthday. Have a nice time. Talk to you soon.
Hi Hylary, just wishing you a happy birthday today. I hope you have a great time, lockdown and all.
Just having a drink, cheers, under the palm trees in Wimbledon Lodge. It was too cold today, Hylary. I was going to put on the lycras for you, but it was just a bit too cold. So anyway, cheers, have a
cheers.
Great day.
Talk soon, bye.
Yeah, talk. Hi Hylary, I couldn't believe when I heard that this was a special birthday for you. Sorry we can't be there, but greetings from Lansdowne anyway.
Hi Hylary, very happy birthday to you. Sorry we can't celebrate with you, but maybe in British this summer, hopefully.
Hi Hylary, wishing you a very happy birthday. Sorry we can't celebrate together. And I don't care what anybody says, you don't look a day over 79. And I'm down here with Ross and Jennifer for a cup of coffee, and do you know what they have me do? I've got to iron.
He has to earn his keep somehow, Hylary, you know what it's like.
No such thing as a free coffee.
But just hoping that we'll all be together soon and hopefully renew our weekends away as well. I mean, 20 years they're going, we've had to miss out one. Hopefully not two.
Okay, very happy birthday from
happy
us all.
Birthday.
Oh.
Happy 80th birthday, Hylary.
You don't look 80, but happy birthday.
Thinking of all the fun and holidays we've had over the years, France in particular, and of course Gordon Bennett outings where there was lots and lots of Fs.
Exactly. And we've had barbecues and just fabulous food all along the way. And
Good laughs
and a good bit of wine, played cards, played bull, all the laughs that we've had. Okay, have a lovely birthday. And also, Peter, can't forget you last year. Well, we belated
80th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Peter.
Have a lovely time. See you soon.
Cheers.
Bye.
Cheers.
Hi, Hylary. Wishing you a really, really happy birthday. I can't wait till all this madness is finished and you and myself and Judy can sit out on the deck with a glass of something really nice and celebrate in style. Hope you have a great day. All my love.
This is my first selfie, so it just shows my age. Here we are, we want to give you a good surprise to say happy birthday, Hylary. Oh dear, I'm sorry, Millie decided to move. Anyway, just to wish you a happy day with Peter, and hopefully very soon you will be able to get with your family and friends at your mobile home that you tell me so much about. I love you both very much. Have a good day. Bye. Linda.
Probably sat beside you on the sofa right now, so you're getting me in stereo at this moment. So this wasn't the plan. I just assumed we'd be in some country house somewhere at this point with all the family celebrating 80 fabulous years, but unfortunately COVID has put heed to that. And I hope this video has gone a little way to show you the love and appreciation that's there for you, and to celebrate 80 fabulous years. It's actually been really nice working on this, putting this together, looking back through photos, listening to videos as they came back in. So it's actually been an emotional few weeks. It's amazing when you look back how much gets packed into 80 years. So I want to thank you for being an amazing mother to me. I think we're so different in so many ways, but we have this really special relationship that I really, really value. You're not just a mother, you're like a best friend to me, and I really treasure what we have, and I never take it for granted. At least I hope I don't take it for granted. I probably did lots in my teenage years. So 3 years ago, actually it's coming up, it must be 4 years now. 4 years ago we got the keys for Britis. That was a dream for so long, and I guess one of the unexpected bonuses, which I hadn't quite anticipated, was actually the joy from living just 100 metres away from me for a few months of the year. Not just for me, but also for Shane and the kids. It's meant a huge amount to us to be so close, and the ease at which our lives kind of work around each other, you know, dropping in for coffee, having a glass of wine, dropping up for dinner last minute, going for walks, and it's just been gorgeous and added a whole new dimension to Britis, which I hadn't anticipated. Britis is already a haven, but this just adds something special to it as well. So I look forward to getting back down and celebrating with everyone properly then, and getting back into that gorgeous routine of just being able to hang out whenever we want to. I have one birthday wish, however, and you won't be surprised to hear it. My birthday wish is to spoil yourself more. And that means buying the fabulous pair of shoes, even if you've absolutely nothing to go with them, or buying the gorgeous outdoor furniture for the deck, just because you can, and it's a treat. So please spoil yourself more this year. I would love to see it more than anything else. So here's to you, Mum. I toast you this evening for a fabulous 80 years. As everybody has said, you look amazing. You have so much energy, and you've always a twinkle in your eyes, and I really admire it, and I respect it, and I have nothing but love in my heart for you. So happy birthday. Mwah. Love you lots. Bye.